Let's learn about muscle contraction physiology. Two important proteins in muscle are actin and myosin. The goal is to get them together. Let's take a closer look at muscle tissue. Muscle contains contractile units. These contractile units contain the protein filaments actin and myosin. The units are called sarcomeres. Let's take a closer look at these filaments. Actin, also known as the thin filament, is a double helix protein. Actin has another double helix protein called the troponin-tropomyosin complex wrapped around it. Here is the tropomyosin. And here is the troponin. Myosin, also known as the thick filament, is close to actin. Remember, the goal is to get actin and myosin together, but they need a little help. Help begins at the motor neuron, which is connected to muscle at an area called the motor end plate. The nervous system sends a message called an action potential down the motor neuron. The motor neuron responds by releasing the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. Acetylcholine floats across the synaptic cleft to the motor end plate on the muscle. It then binds to receptors. This causes sodium channels to open. Sodium flows into the motor end plate and it depolarizes. Before we go any further, we need to introduce another important structure. This is a network of membranous channels that wraps around the muscle fibers called the sarcoplasmic reticulum. When the muscle is at rest, calcium is actively transported into the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Remember that active transport uses ATP. This creates a large calcium gradient. When the muscle depolarizes, the sarcoplasmic reticulum releases calcium. The calcium binds to the troponin portion of the troponin-tropomyosin complex. The complex moves, exposing the myosin binding site on the actin. Now myosin can bind with actin, forming a cross bridge. Myosin moves actin and is powered by ATP. The sarcomere shortens and the muscle contracts. This process repeats as long as the stimulation and calcium are present. Actin and myosin are finally together. We hope you've learned something about muscle contraction, and see you next time.